Hello friend, welcome to StackPhy, and if you help me to solve today's physics problem till the end of the video, then you get a cookie. So let's go. Hey, what's up everyone? I hope all of you are doing great. This is Ramesh Zaman and I welcome you all to a new video. And today we'll be solving an epic question from Ampere's loop law. So in this question, they have said that an infinitely long wire lying along z-axis carrying a current I flowing towards positive z direction. Fine. There is no other current, considering a circle in xy plane with center at 200 and radius is 1 meter. Divide the circle in small segments and let dl denote the length of a small segment in anti-clockwise direction as shown. Okay, fine. So what are our questions? The questions, first question is consider two point A 300 and 210 on the given circle. The path integral A to B, B dot dl of the total magnetic field along the perimeter of the given circle from A to B. So we need to find out this integration starting from A to B. Okay, and it is the line integral of the magnetic field along this perimeter. See, that's fair enough. So the current here is coming towards our face at the positive z-axis, and I am interested in finding out B dot dl for this path. So I'm taking a loop because Ampere's law is favorable for a loop, and my loop is A to B, B to C and C to A again. So what is B to C or C to B? So this BC is the portion of a circle putting this point as the center. That means the magnetic field due to this current carrying wire forms a circular loop. Okay, see these small arrows, these are nothing but the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so this will help us a lot for our question. Now see, this loop does not enclose any current. Okay, so we can say that for this loop ABC, according to Ampere's loop law, closed line integral of B dot dl is 0, okay, because there is no current enclosed. Now if you break this whole loop in three parts, A, B, B, C and C, A, it should be 0 again. Now integration of C to A B dot dl will be 0. Why? Because for this path, the magnetic field due to this current is always perpendicular. Okay, doesn't matter what is the magnitude, but the direction of the magnetic field is always perpendicular to this path. So the dot product will be 0. So this terms become 0. Very nice. So we have A to B is equal to negative B to C. So just removing the negative sign, we just change our path C to B. So integration C to B, C B. Okay, now if you consider the path C B, you will see that the magnetic field makes an angle 0 degree at each and every point, keeping its magnitude constant. So cos 0. So we'll take B out from the integration. So integration C to B dl is nothing but the length of this arc, which is this, if I consider this as r, so this length would be r theta. Okay, so this one will be r theta, and B is nothing but the magnetic field at every point on this arc, which is mu naught by 2 pi I by r. Okay, mu naught by 2 pi I by r, and the length of the arc is r theta, right? So r gets cancelled out. What is theta? So we have tan theta as bc by oc. Okay, so tan theta is half, because this radius is 1 and this is 2. So 1 by 2, just put the value of theta, tan inverse half. So this will be our final answer, option B. So here is option B, this one. Okay. So let us go to our second question. The maximum value of path integral B dot dl, the total magnetic field along the perimeter given in the circle. Okay, so we need to find out the maximum value of integration B dot dl, where we'll integrate it along the perimeter. Fine. So I've taken a random situation here. So integration A to B B dot dl will be equal to negative integration of A to B via this path. right? Makes sense, right? So because we can say that A to B via, or we can write properly A1B B dot dl will be equal to integration of B to A with a negative sign B dot dl, just this and this, right? So if we just integrate it A to B, okay, so we can write down the general equation as mu naught by 2 pi I times this angle theta for this arc, okay, because this is for path 1 and this one is for path 2, okay, and we can easily find out for path 2 the angle theta, okay. Now for max value of AB dot dl, B dot dl, we need the maximum value of theta, and we'll get the maximum value of theta only when these two chords will touch the tangent, will form the tangent on this circle, okay. And for forming the tangent, the corresponding diagram would look something like this. So if this angle is theta by 2, so we can write that sine theta by 2 is perpendicular divided by hypotenuse. So theta by 2 is pi by 6, theta is pi by 3, and our final answer would be how much? So this one is for path 1, this one is for path 2. Just put the value of pi by 3, we will get mu naught I by 6. Okay, so option C is the correct answer. So I hope you all have found this video helpful and informative, and it might have helped you for your preparation in your exam. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace, take care. As you have come to the end of the video, you get a cookie. I'll see you in the next one. Peace, take care.